Good morning. Today I would like to give my presentation about the PE exam. The PE exam is the guideline for final exam. The PE exam consists of two questions. The first step is about the ACL on router, and for the second lab is about the ACL on firewall. Let's have a look on first lab. This is network diagram. First of all, you have to know how many network in this diagram. In this diagram, we have one, two, three, four. Okay, there are four network in this diagram. So this means we need four network address for four network. And for the LAN ones, okay. The LAN 1 network address is 192.168.1.0. And for the WAN 1, 192.168.3.0. And the LAN 2 network address is 192.168.2.0. And for the LAN 3, its network address is 192.168.4.0. And okay, we have two steps. Actually, we have three steps. First, network design. First, IP address design. Second is routing design. And the third is the cybersecurity implemented by using the ACL. We have first three steps. Anyway, for this network diagram, IP address design is given like this. So we just concentrate only the second step and third step. Okay. So for the routing and ACL. For the routing. Now we have two choice for routing configuration. The first is default rules, and second is static rules. From this diagram, the sub area, there are two sub area. First, on the IA, okay. IA on the left hand side, this is sub area because there is only one gateway. And another sub area at the RC, the right hand side of RC, it is also sub area. So we can set default rules on the router A and router C. For the router B, we cannot set default rules because router B there are two gateway. Okay. So this means the router B, we have to set the static rules. Okay, LAN 1, okay. WAN 1, LAN 2, and LAN 3. Okay. After we can decide our routing configurations, the next step we have to consider about the cyber security policy. Okay, from this diagram, the requirement ones in 192.168.2.0/24. This means network address of LAN 2. In rank two, we allow only 192.168.0.51.0 /25 to access the web and ping of the web server of 192.168.2.2/24. Okay, and where is the web server? You can see this is web server 192.168.2.2. Okay, this is web server. Web server is inside the LAN 2. And for the database server 0.4.2 inside LAN 3. Okay, for the this network diagram, the client they are on the LAN 1. Okay. 0.1.2, 0.1.3, 0.1.195, 0.1.16, 0.1.196. Okay. The client on the LAN, they are on the LAN 1. And we have to set the policy allow the some client to can access the web server. Some client can access the database server. And we have to allow the web server can access database server also. Okay, back to the see the requirements. Okay, the requirement one is allow only 0.1.0/25 to access the web and ping service of web server. Okay. /25. This means the full CASI is divided by two. First part and second part. The first part of network address 0.1.0. This means the first part of this network address is in range of 0.1.0 until 0.1.1. 27, okay. Half of class C. So you can see the PC 0.1.2 and 0.1.3, they are in the first part, right? They are in the the subnet. The subnet of 0.1.0/25 and 0.195 and 0.16 196 they are in the second part. Okay, this means from this requirements is allow only 0.1.2 and 0.1.3 can access the service of web server 0.2.2 and the web service and this web server open to service. The first service is the web access and ping access. Okay, this is the requirement one. And let's see for the requirement two in the LAN 3. It's allow only 0.1.0/25. Okay, we know 0.1.0/25 mean the 0.1.2 and 0.1.3 in the LAN 1. And 0.2.2 mean the web server, right? To access the web service of database server 0.4.2. You can see 0.4.2 is database server that is located in LAN 3, right? So this means the requirement to allow 0.1.2 and 0.1.3 can access the web service of the database server, allow only one service. And it also allow web server can access the database server This is the document of this is the document tool. So for the final exam, you have to given the requirement like this, you have to try to understand after you understand, okay, understand the requirements, okay, and then you convert the requirement into the ACL rule. Okay, for the testing, okay, for the requirement ones, okay, allow 0.1, 0.0, 725 to access the ping of web server, okay, from the 0.1, 0.2, okay, call add the PCA. PCA can ping to 0.2, 0.2, 0.2, 0.2 is the web server, right? So PCA can ping web server, okay? And in contrast, for the 0.1, 0.195, this is the this is in the second part of subnet, right? This is the second part of class C. So 0.195 is yes. Okay. Okay, and 0.1, sorry, 0.195 is in the second part, right? So it cannot ping to the web server. Okay, because from the our policy, we allow only the first part, that are the PCA 0.1, 0.2, and PCB 0.1, 0.3 can ping. Okay. And okay, from okay, this proof, okay, PCA 0.1, 0.2 is able to ping to the web server. On the other hand, 0.195 is unable to ping to the web server. And for the web service, PCA 0.1, 0.2 can access the web service of web server 0.2, 0.2. In contrast, 0.195 cannot access the web service of web server. Okay, this means is now we can convert ACL follow the requirement once. Okay. Okay, let's have a look for the requirement tool. For the requirement tool at the line 3, allow only 0.1, 0.0, 725. This means the first part, and allow 0.2, 0.2 is the web server to access the web service of database server in LAN 3. Its IP address is 0.4, 0.2. Okay, let's have a look for the testing. At the PCA 0.1, 0.2 can ping to cannot ping to the database server 0.4, 0.2. Okay, for the summation, for the summary, PCA 0.1, 0.2 can ping to the web server, but it cannot ping to the database server. And let's have a look on the 0.195. 0.195 can ping to the web server, but it also cannot ping to the database server. Okay, for the web server, okay, web server is 0.2, 0.2, and its location is in the LAN 2. The web server Camping back to the PCA point one point two okay and the web server cannot ping to the database server point four point two okay this is follow the requirement to and for the web service you can see PCA can access the web service of database server in contrast point 195 cannot access the web service of the database server. Okay. And let's check for the web server. Okay, web server point 2.2 can access the web service of database server point 4.2 that is in the RAN 3. Okay. This is the web server point 2.2 can access the web service of point 4.2. Okay.